fire questions.
Yeah.
So quick answers back. Maybe a little short why on why you said what you said.
Okay.
So, first one. Best player you've ever played with? You can't say me.
Right.
Someone else.
Best player I've played with. I think the best partnership I had was with Neil Lennon.
Finding Lennon. He skips past Kinsella. Now has Rufus to contend with. Taggart back to Lennon! It's a beauty from Neil Lennon.
As a midfield player, when I was at Chelsea, I played with people like Nigel Spatman. These kids were all over. He played for Liverpool. I played with Alan Dickens. I played for West Ham. Mm-hmm. Played with Lee Willett. You know, he played a few times in the reserves, and you think, mate, it's another level. Yeah. You know what I mean? That's another time. But as a partnership and someone I learned from and respected as a football player with Neil Lennon, I think.
Yeah. And he brought something different to the team than what you did.
Yeah, he brought something in me as well, because he was I worked hard, he worked hard. He had a title, but we had an understanding, like a connection.
Yeah.
On and off the pitch, really. But I'd say Neil Lennon because of that reason. I think we complemented each other's styles.
Yeah, he was a great player. Best player against?
The best player I ever played against was against Zinedine Zidane.
World Cup?
No, I played against him in a friendly for Turkey. He was playing for France. And he played just behind, he played like the number 10, mm-hmm. as you call it. And talk about spatial awareness and everything. It looked like he was on the pitch by himself. Mm-hmm. It was like I'm running around like little Turks sprinting everywhere trying to put my foot in. And every time he got it, I remember once he got it and he pinged it, I don't know, 30, 40 yards out to like someone on the wing.
Mm-hmm.
But when he pinged it, I didn't look to see where he pinged it, I looked at what he'd done, and he went like that as if he'd shanked it.
Mm-hmm.
And then I quickly looked up and this ball just going like that, like a missile, straight to whoever it was on the right wing. And I thought, so even when he shanks it, go straight to it. That's how good he is. You know?
Mate, he's probably one of my favourite players of all time. Him, Rivaldo.
Played against Rivaldo.
Really? One of my favourite. Yeah. Grew up looking at him and trying to aspire to be like him. Never got there, obviously, but.
Well, you've done well, mate, in your career. You've done well.
But Zidane, what a player. Best goal?
People are going to say this over a kick.
Stretch leg of the defender and hooks the ball across here. Oh, fantastic goal, Muzzy, is it? What a goal from the Turkish international.
But I scored a goal as a kid growing up. You know, like you go back to the
school. Yeah, yeah. That's where my favourite goal comes from.
My favourite goal was, I was playing in a practice match at Chelsea. I was playing against, I think it was Wickham. So Wickham had come to our training ground to play like an under-21s match because we wanted to give some of our first team players a run out and stuff. And I was playing, and Glenn Hoddle was playing for us as well.
Mm.
And he was playing like he did then, sweeper. Mm. And he come out there and he could ping a ball.
Yeah.
You know, he's passing this. Ridiculous, he's passing. Mm. And he's pinged it, and I've made a forward run through the middle, sort of. So I've just gone past the centre circle bit, I'm running into their box, I'm in between the box and the centre circle. So I'm about halfway in, and I've sprinted onto this pass that he's hit to me. And it was just there, and I remember flicking it in full speed, no earlier than I, and I flicked it over my head as I'm running, and the centre half's come out, it's gone over his head, and as it came down, I volleyed it in the left foot into the top corner on the edge of the box, and I was like,
couldn't believe it.
Yeah, it was one of them, and it's always stuck in your head. I can't believe it. I wish I'd scored that, like, as a first thing. It wasn't, it was one man, his dog saw it. That was my favourite goal.
But has it had other ideas? One of which was to find the corner of the net. Feigns and cuts inside, has made himself some space for a supreme shot. Four up for him. Just cleared there straight out to, is it? Is it good? Is it brilliant? Muzzy, is it? Has seen an unstoppable shot.
Best manager.
It'd have to be Martin Young, because he sort of, he was the one who brought the confidence that I needed at the time into me. We talk about management and how important it is in Roy Hodgson, why it didn't work and everything else. What Martin had a great knack of doing was making football uncomplicated.
Yeah.
You know, going, right, this is simple game. This is your job only. Not stick me in a position where I'm playing right wing and having to sort of do step overs, because that ain't my game.
Yeah.
So he put you in your position and go, right, that's what I need from you. And he'd done that with everyone. And it worked for me. You know, I think sometimes managers now with these different formations are overcomplicating it for players, and I don't think they quite understand their role in the team.
Yeah. Your LCFC team, because your LCFC team won a League Cup, got to the final of another League Cup.
Won two League Cups.
Lost one, so three League Cups you got to the final of. 1-2, came 7th in the Premier League twice.
Yeah, something like that.
Yeah. Or that team, who wins out of that team and the team that just won the Premier League, Leicester? I think it would have been a great game.
Yeah, I think, if I say us, I look like a bitter old...
Well, do you know what it is? This is what I would say for everyone watching. I think back then, Man United, Chelsea, Liverpool,
Arsenal,
all these teams were better than they probably are now.
I'd agree with that.
So if them teams were still as good as that now, Leicester, if they finished 6th or 7th, it would have been about the same.
Yeah, but it's not... underestimate what Leicester City achieved last year. It's incredible.
No, it is.
It's incredible. But if you go through the top, say, six clubs in the Premier, take Leicester City out of it for a minute, and just pick, or just go through their centre forwards now. So if you go through Liverpool centre forward now, is it Benteke?
Benteke.
Right. You go through Arsenal's centre forward now. Giroud. You go through Man United centre forward now, without Slatton, it's Rooney.
Yeah,
Rooney coming to the nutshell, to the end of his career. You go through, who else is there?
Chelsea.
Go through Chelsea centre forward now, Diego Costa.
Yeah.
And Man City, I think Man City is the only one who's got a centre forward now that's better
than back then.
Aguero is amazing player.
Yeah.
So you go through my year as such, Arsenal had Bergkamp and Henry. If you go Man United, you went Van Nistelrooy, Cole, Solskjaer,
Van Persie.
You go Liverpool, Michael Owen, Robbie Fowler, who else was there back then? Even Heskey played for them.
Heskey.
So that's the level back then. You know, we're not talking, what was that, 98, 97, 98, so nearly 10 years ago. So you was up against some real top class strikers. It's about the midfielders, you know, Vieira and Petit for Arsenal, Man United, Keane, Scholes, Beckham, Ronaldo. So there were some great players back then. Maybe the standard in them clubs had dipped a bit. I think it's fair to say.
I think it has.
I think the standard at Liverpool dipped. Liverpool's more so been like that for a while. Man United's midfield is average at the best of times.
Is it fair to say it would have just been a good game? I think it would have been a good game.
I think we would have given a good game.
Won?
I think it would have been, I don't know if we would have won, but you know, back then now.
Well, it would have been Lenny up against Kante, wouldn't it?
Yeah, they're
about to. It would have been your against Drinkwater.
Yeah, they're about to have dealt with Heskey and Collymore up front. You know, we had a good keeper in Ian Walker. We had
good centre backs.
Strong centre
backs. Tags. Walsh, Elliot.
Yeah. So So we had decent players. You know, we had, and people forget about him, and I think he was a great player, Theo Zacharakis. He won the European Thingy Cup.
Captain.
They called it that team. You know what I mean? So we had some good players.
Yeah.
Theo was a wicked player.
Mm. So that's why I used to look at it as a 17-year-old thinking, how am I going to get in this team?
He was a good player. No, but I think it would have been a tough game. I don't know who would have beaten him, but it would have been a good game.
Ronaldo or Messi?
You know what? I've said Ronaldo for a long time because he scores all types of goals. Mm. You know, last night, his header last night was incredible.
Yeah, it was.
Incredible. His technique's amazing. But I'm gonna stick with Ronaldo. Stick with Ronaldo because I like Messi more. Mm. I like Messi more because he seems like a humble sort of. He perceives to be a humble sort of bloke on the pitch. Mm. Ronaldo could be the nicest bloke in the world off it, but on it, he can be a bit selfish, kind.
Yeah.
But mate, when you're scoring 50 goals a season, you can sort of do what you want.
Yeah. Best player of all time?
Diego Maradona.
Control the play in midfield, the way that Maradona has been able to do. And he's hurting England again here. It's a brilliant run. It's one of the World Cup great goals.
By country mile, I don't even think you can put Messi near him. And I think Messi's great. And the reason I say it is because I think Maradona could inspire. Yeah. His team dragging through.
He was that good. I think so.
Yeah, I think he was. Messi's got a much better goal scoring record than him. Maradona could score great goals. I think that was one thing I'd say Messi's better than him at, and that would be more of a consistent goal scorer. Mm. But I think Maradona could galvanise his team and inspire his team to greatness.
Mm.
I don't think Messi in the Argentinian team done that. Mm. So that's why I want to say Diego Maradona.
Muzz, top man for coming on the channel.
Yeah, mate.
Sharing your thoughts with us. Hopefully you'll come on again soon, because I ain't even spoke about, you know, the World Cup semi-final. You played in the World Cup semi-final. Yeah. You've played in big finals. You've played, I had a look on Wiki before I come, played 300 Premier League games, nearly 300 Premier League games. So there's a lot of information in there that we'd love to get out of you. But for this one, big man,
always a pleasure.
Thanks for coming, my brother. Top man.